Hi everyone, this is Jason here from Nathaniel. In this lesson, we're going to learn how to build minor progressions, minor chord progressions, if you will, right? They come from minor scales pretty much, or you can build them in some instances even without the scale, just learning a few nice sounding chords. And whenever we say minor chord progressions, you know, or minor progressions in general, we don't necessarily mean only minor chords, right? That'll tend to sound like only sad. You know, here we are trying to get more different colors or different emotions or different themes using chords. But generally, when we say the minor theme, we mean things like melancholic, pensive, you know, yearning for something you can't get, or bravery, or perhaps, as you'll see at the later part of the lesson, you can even get a very epic sounding vibe, you know, a very victorious kind of vibe. So minor may not be very, you know, cheerful or very, you know, happy, you know, to say the least, or very playful, but there can be a lot of other moods and obviously a lot of other themes which you can build around these chord progressions. I've tried to make the lesson as simple as possible without involving too much theory, but there is a little bit of theory needed. So I would really suggest that you get your pens, your papers out, and your keyboards out if possible. You can play a lot of this stuff along with me, and let's get cracking now. So to start building any chord progression, we tend to just use 3 to 4 chords. I'm using pretty much the bare minimum, which is 3 chords. And what are the 3 chords? We have an interesting subject in music called as functional harmony, where each of the chords are named or formed based on their energy levels, if you will, right? So generally with functional harmony, you'll have the first chord, which is your predominant chord. Well, you could have any first chord, but if ever you do have this so-called predominant chord, or some people call it the subdominant chord, you know, its purpose is to resolve to another chord called as the dominant chord. And the dominant chord is also rather unstable. The dominant chord will then in turn resolve to the tonic chord. And as you can hear, these are just normal triads. G minor, A dominant or A major, and D minor. But for some reason, the D minor feels like home. It feels the most stable, right? And these are things which I guess you can't explain. This is the physics of music. You can't really change what is there on planet Earth. We are just there to enjoy it, I guess, as music makers and even music listeners. So the whole idea behind this whole lesson is to show you that you just have these energy states, right? You have the predominant bass, which gets more unstable to the dominant, and that resolves to the tonic. In this case, minor. Play that again so you can just keep that vibe going. La-da-doo-doo. And of course, a melody can be built through the chord progression. Try out some other predominance. Da, 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 da. Color up the dominant. Color up the tonic. Right? But the functions remain the same. Let's get used to the vibe further. Right? Predominant. You can even make it more, you know, more heavy or more brave. And then, you know, maybe desolate and sad. You have all these options available. So the chords which I'm using for this entire lesson are pretty much 3 chords if you think about it. There's G minor, there's A major, and there's D minor. But it's important to understand the roles of each of these chords. The G minor is what we call as the predominant. It serves the role as the predominant chord, right? And I'm on the key of D minor. I should have said that earlier, but I'm in the key of D minor. Now, whenever you're dealing with harmonizing a minor scale, you have to understand that the seventh note can either be a flat 7, in this case C, or could even be a C sharp, right, which is the leading note, or it could be C. So these are the two minor scale options you have. The one with the C is called as the natural minor. That's called as the harmonic minor, right? So we are going to bring in both flavors. So whenever you're composing chord progressions on a minor scale, you pretty much have these variants, right? You even have the Dorian, which we can get into in another lesson. So you have the chords now. You have the G minor, which is the first chord. Now, if you think about it, G minor is the 4 minor with respect to whether it's D minor or D harmonic minor. You'll have G as the fourth. So that's the fourth minor. Okay. Going to the 5 major, which I'm playing as A major here. So I'm borrowing notes from the harmonic minor scale, which has that C sharp, which has a great pull towards the D minor. Actually, A major can even resolve to D major, but this is not a major lesson. So you have A major resolving to D minor, right? If you had A minor, it could also resolve to D minor, but it's more common to play that dominant A major sound, and that resolves strongly, if you will, to D minor. So G minor, A, D. So you have G minor, A major, D minor, right? Let's just get acquainted with these three chords. Ba-da, A, D. And we are trying to play D minor a bit longer in the piece. G minor, A major, D minor, ba-da-ba-da. Because we stay at home a bit more, right? G minor. So it's common to do this with the home chord a bit longer. Ba-da, ba-da, A, ba-da-ba-da. Now, I've composed a melody which can be used, I guess, throughout this lesson for the most part, right? You could just use this as a kind of template melody. You don't have to necessarily play it on the piano. You can pretty much just sing it, because this lesson is about coming up with the chord progression in the first place, right? I'd leave the melody even to you. You can improvise it, but for the purpose of this lesson, we'll go with something like this. Ta-da, ta-da-da. Singing it along. Okay. So that's the melody. These are the chords. So once you've got cracking with the melody and the chords, well, the chord progression kind of sounds nice. It could build us a song on its own, isn't it? Because it has that functional pull or that magnetic attraction to each other. And it all also has that looping concept where you can repeat it for the whole song and it'll sound great if you ask me. So in this lesson, as part of a series of videos on exploring minor chord progressions, we are going to use this as the template and kind of stop with this. We have the predominant minor, the dominant major, ending on the tonic minor, and try to sing that melody along. You can even play it if you want on the piano. Play the chords in the left and the tune in the right. Right? So that's pretty much it for this part of this lesson series. Now we are going to do a lot more parts which are going to come your way to explore minor chord progressions. So I'd suggest to practice this one and head over to the next video where what we are going to do is we are going to look at a vast amount of options in order to color up these minor progressions. And remember, by minor, it doesn't mean only using minor chords. There are going to be all sorts of chords. We are going to look at diminished chords, augmented chords, some jazz tensions, some passing chords or slash chords, secondary dominants, and tritone subs. The list is going on, and I'm forgetting some of the options. So come over to the next part and we are going to explore minor chord progressions together. If you have any doubts regarding this lesson, do leave us a comment and also support the video and our channel by giving it a thumbs up, perhaps leaving a comment, sharing the video with your musician friends. And if you haven't already, hit subscribe and don't forget to turn on the bell icon for regular notifications. I will see you in the next part.